Dear students, we have already seen the three sessions on the poem called Homecoming Sun. So now in this session, we will have a revision on this poem. So as I told you in my last video lectures, now we can have a look on the objective of the poem here. So here the poet tries to evoke the interest for motherland, and he tries to inculcate the feeling of divinity for native land, and in turn to reduce the obsessiveness for a foreign land. So now you look at the word called divinity. The poet has a divine feeling towards his native land, and also he tells the people of Ethiopia to have the same feeling for their motherland. The poem gives a call for homecoming to young generations. So the poet is not simply inviting the young generations for the native land, but instead he gives a very powerful call for returning to their homeland. The poem exhibits the pride of native culture. So students, look at the use of the word, the pride. The poet has a very pride feeling for his native culture and the glory of its motherland. The poem shows the pride for embracing the glory of Ethiopian culture. So throughout the poem, the Ethiopian culture and its need for the people, it becomes the main objective of the poem. So now if you look at the theme of the poem, so here the poet, at the beginning of the poem itself, he says, I want to welcome the homecoming son and his need for the country. He says that the returning of the son, or the returning of the young generations to their homeland, it is the need of the hour. And he says, to show the pride for the black color and the black culture. According to the poet, it is very unique, the black culture and its the black color. It has its own uniqueness in it. He calls them as strangers who live in a foreign land, who might have forgotten the feel of a native land. According to the poet, it is a big crime to stay in a foreign land and to forget the feeling of one's motherland. So now the theme is continued here. He asked them to look back for their ancestors and their culture. As you have seen in the last lectures, here the poet very symbolically tells that the ancestors, they become a very important thing in one's lives, because they symbolize the past culture, the past history of a given land. The poet asks them to enjoy the caress of the native land. The poet says the native land is something like a mother who has a special care for her son. So one should enjoy the caress of his own motherland. The poet talks about the need for a lost son to both his family and country. Here the poet very emotionally tells that if a family loses its own son, the country also cries for them, because the country is also awaiting for the returning of its native people. He gives a call for them to embrace their roots and become one with the mother earth. So here the question of root, that becomes very important in the poem. He asks the young generation to embrace their roots, and they should become one with the mother earth. This is the main theme of the poem. So there are many important things the poet tries to convey here. And if you look at some of the key points in this revision, what you could see that the point number one is the importance of motherland. The second point is call for a homecoming. The third point, importance of embracing the roots of the country. The fourth point, to show the love for the black culture. And the fifth point is to exhibit the pride for Ethiopian culture and its heritage. So now we have come to the end of the session. So students, if you look at all the four sessions in your reading, you will definitely have a better understanding of the poem. Thank you.